Leonard Lesline, Senior Design Engineer with VPT Incorporated, and today I'll be discussing the synchronization of multiple DC to DC converters. Several families of VPT's DC to DC converters offer the capability of synchronizing the switching frequency. The families listed here, DVGF plus, DVHF plus, DVHB, DVSB, DVTR, DVWR, VPT 100 and VPT 30 all offer synchronization input capability, which means with an external signal, these converters can be synchronized to the same frequency. It's a block diagram showing two converters that have this sync in capability. They would run off the same input bus, and then a signal would run from an external synchronization source to synchronize the converters together at the same switching frequency. VPT also offers converter families that, in addition to the sync in pin, also have a sync out pin, which can be used to synchronize multiple other converters to the same frequency as the master converter that is used with its sync out pin. This one thing to remember that the sync signals on all of the converters, sync in and sync out, are referenced to the primary ground. So all grounding has to be referenced to the primary when hooking up the synchronization capability. The families that offer the sync out are the DVFL and the DV200 family of converters. One thing to remember when using the sync out pin to synchronize converters from different converter families is that you must look on the data sheet, which is located on our website, to find out what the allowable synchronization frequency of the converters that you're syncing to the master converter are. The synchronization input signal specifications are the same for all VPT converters. It should be a TTL compatible signal with a maximum amplitude of 6 volts. The signal should never be allowed to go more than 0.3 volts below zero to prevent damage to the synchronization input pin. And the duty cycle of the signal should always be maintained between 20 and 80%. Now I'd like to go to the lab and give a brief demonstration of synchronizing two converters together. Now I'd like to demonstrate the synchronization of two DVFLs using the sync out pin from one FL to feed the sync in pin of the second FL. On the screen, the scope is triggered to the sync out pin of the first DVFL, and the second trace that's running free against that is the sync out pin of the second DVFL. And I'll demonstrate closing a switch to connect the sync out pin to the sync in pin of the second converter, and you will see that they come into synchronization. You now see that both DVFL converters are running at the same switching frequency. And this concludes the discussion of the synchronization capabilities of VPT's DC to DC converters. Thank you.